Well, welcome, Airport Design Challengers. Rob Lowe here, Regional Administrator for the Southwest U.S. for the Federal Aviation Administration. Great to see you again, and congratulations on making it this far in our Airport Design Challenge. I am so proud of all of you. Can you believe 6 weeks ago, a mere 6 weeks ago, wow, we started this journey together, and you all have made amazing progress. The submissions you've turned in have been fantastic. The detail is incredible. The realism, the accuracy is just phenomenal. Let's take one final look at some of your airport submissions. You see me zooming like a 747. I know it's heaven, but it's getting so real. It's a dream. I'm elevated and I just want to take it with my head in the clouds and feet on the ground. Yeah. You see me zooming like a 747. I know it's heaven, but it's getting so real. It's a dream. I'm elevated, but I just want to take you in my head in the clouds and feel the ground. You all are just amazing. Those were spectacular. Well, I hope that we've sparked an interest for you in the aviation industry through this design challenge. One of our goals was not only to show you how airports are designed and all the many, many complex things that go into airports, we really wanted you to get a glimpse of what a fantastic thing being part of the aviation community is. Whether you're a pilot, an air traffic controller, a technician, an engine mechanic, an engineer, there are so many opportunities for you in the aviation industry. That was our goal. We wanted you to know there is virtually anything you want to do, it's likely available in the aviation industry. You know, there's things in our future that are going to change incredibly. Throughout this challenge, we've been in a lot of hangars. You recall you've seen me inside of big hangars at a large airport. You've seen me outside of hangars at a small airport. We've been outside a very large commercial airport at Dallas-Fort Worth. We've seen building structures that you've replicated and put on your airports in all kinds of fashions. Well, today I wanted to show you a different kind of hangar and talk a little bit about the future of our national airspace system. Today I'm in my own hangar. Actually, it's my garage, but it's my hangar. I'm an avid remote control RC pilot. So RC stands for remote control airplane. A lot of you may be familiar with the term drone, and then you come up with an image of a quadcopter, right? Well, our current national airspace system, we classify all of that as unmanned aerial systems, or UAS. Whether you're flying a quadcopter or an RC airplane like I have all of mine here, those are all unmanned aerial systems, and the future is incredibly bright for UAS. Not too distant, you will see drones or UASs making deliveries, likely to your house, maybe bringing you things like a prescription or some food or something like that. You know, there are lots of other applications that are in the works. There are what we call urban mobility vehicles or electric vertical takeoff and landing vehicles. You know, there's companies out there working right now to build a taxi that has an electric motor and some that have a gas motor, but they want to power this taxi, bring it to you at your house, take you to an airport or somewhere else you want to go in an unmanned vehicle. No pilot. Can you imagine? And folks just like you with an interest in aviation and the aviation industry are going to get to design and build and fly and be part of that. It's really, really exciting. There are all kinds of things in our national airspace system that are emerging. Another huge area is commercial space. Within the last few weeks, you saw the United States launch American astronauts on American rockets from American soil. We haven't done that for a really, really long time. We are at the dawn of a new space age. That's just incredible. What is in your future? Men and women, astronauts, are going to go to the moon. They're going to go to space stations. They will even go to Mars in your lifetime, I'm sure. Our airport design challenge was there to not only let you have some fun using Minecraft, but to learn some about airports and how we operate the National Airspace System. We are really excited about the amazing work that you turned in. You know what? I am incredibly proud of every one of you. Congratulations on making it through the contest. Now, for those of you that might not have got your final submissions turned in by the deadline, don't worry about it. Keep following your guides, your instruction guides. Keep turning in your stuff. Even though the judging may be over, we still want to see what you've done. You know what? You may still have some great ideas that'll help us change the national airspace system. Don't forget, those FAA mentors are still out there as well. I know you have their contact info, so be sure and reach out. I know they'd love to hear from you. We have something really, really, really exciting for you though. Each one of you is invited to our Design Challenge Awards Ceremony. We're going to send you out email invitations soon, but block the date of July 2nd. On July 2nd, we're going to have two award ceremonies. They're going to be virtual, so you can dial in from anywhere. We'll send you the information. We would love to have you attend that. And you get to see the folks that got their submissions in and that get recognized as the top designs in each category. We are so excited to see. And I'm telling you, the competition is tough. I would not want to be a judge. The judges have their work cut out for them because you all have done such amazing work. Again, I'm so incredibly proud of you. I'm amazed at the work you've done. You have used Minecraft and our guides on an airport design to build airports that are, quite frankly, some of them look better than the airport you modeled. And that is amazing. You all have done fantastic work. So congratulations. It's great to see you. Thanks for participating in our Airport Design Challenge. And I look forward to seeing you around the aviation industry in the years to come.